Hello, this is Andreas. Today I'm going to be showing you how to extract the EDID file from your monitor or projector. Okay, what is an EDID file? The EDID file is actually a file which is stored in on your monitor or on your projector, which displays, tells the input device what it is capable of. For instance, when you connect a monitor to your computer, it automatically knows that let's say it's a 1080p capable monitor with a 120Hz refresh rate. What does happen though, in rather rare occasions, is that this EDID file tends to get corrupted, and when it does get corrupted or even deleted, the input source, which might be a PC, a Blu-ray player, a DVD player, a media player, even a PlayStation 4 or an Xbox One, and a couple of other thousands of devices, cannot actually know what that monitor or projector is capable of. So what I'm going to be demonstrating today is that how you can use a friend's monitor or projector to extract the EDID file from their monitor or projector if they're exactly the same, and give it to you, and you can flash it back to your own monitor or projector. Today I'm not going to be showing you how to flash the EDID file back onto the device. I'm just going to show you how you can extract it from a device that is working well. First of all, you'll need to click on the link on the description of this video, okay? And it will take you to this site, which is Troubleshooting DVI and EDID Issues, okay? When you go down to about this level, click on Monitor Asset Manager and Externs Edit Manager. You need to download the both of these. The first one I think is about 4 megabytes, and the second one is just a few kilobytes, so it's gonna be really, really quick. Okay, now I want to NTAC's website, which is a Taiwanese company, and click on the Monitor Asset Manager, which you need to install. As you can see, it's only 699 kilobytes, and it's a really, really small file, program rather. Once you've downloaded, click on it, click Run. I'm using Windows 8.1, by the way. Then click Next, I accept, Next, 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 create a desktop icon, Next, install. Once you install this, keep launch mon info ticked and click on finish, and it will now open up the program. Okay, by now you should have installed, connected the projector or monitor to your PC with an HDMI cable, not with a DVI cable, not with a VGA cable, not with anything else, only with an HDMI cable, only. Once you've connected the projector or monitor, you'll find some options in this box right here, which is display IDs. Remember, don't connect too many displays onto the PC when you're doing this, because it's going to be a bit confusing, okay? The reason I'm doing this video today is because my projector, my Optima HD67, has its edit file corrupted and I'm unable to use my projector at its full capabilities. So if you're the person who I kindly asked to help me, you will find an opt something something here, okay? It will say here Optoma HD67, okay? And you will select that. As you can see here, there are a lot of states on these displays. I have two connected right now, an Acer and a Dell monitor. All these are the same. It's just the first two say it's the real-time monitors which are corrected currently. These are the same monitors which are saved in the registry and are active right now. And these are also the same monitors which are saved in the registry but are not active. You need to select the real-time state of the Optoma HD67 or the display that you need to extract the edit file. But with this program, you're not going to be extracting the edit file, but you're going to be extracting the INF file. The INF file is the driver for that specific monitor you have. So if you extract the INF file, you can right click on the INF file and install it as a driver. So how you do that? Just click on the monitor or projector that you wish, click on file, create INF, click on it, then write the name of the display that you wish. In this case, it is an Acer GD245HQ. Click on desktop and then click on save. Then close the program and check if the INF file is saved on your desktop. As I've said before, when you open it with Notepad, you can see that it displays the capabilities of the projector or monitor to your computer. In this instance, it says 1920 by 1080 at 60 Hertz. Okay, close this. Then you need to go back to the website I was talking about, and this time go to the Extron Electronics. And you will need to sign up for this, okay? Just type a name, minus address, company, I would say, none. Then email, I'll just add my email, because they won't just let you download this program. You need to add your email, and they will email the link to you, and then you can download the link. In my case, because I've done it before, I just click on Download Edit Manager V1X0 and it will immediately start downloading. As you can see, it's just a 3.5 megabyte file. Just click on Save File. It's already downloaded. Then click on the file so you can install it and it will start up. Then click on next, I accept, next, next. Make sure this is ticked and then click on finish. Minimize and I'll bring this here. Click on the edit manager so you can open it up and then click on load edit from registry. Here it will give you a couple of options. These are all the same monitor. It's the Acer monitor and these two are the Dell monitor. Make sure that when you select the monitor that you need, here it must say digital, okay? Because I only need, or you only need, the edit file from the HDMI connection. So let's find out where's the digital output. Okay, as you can see, In my case, it will be an Optima opt something something, and when you click on one of the choices, it will say Optima HD67 parentheses digital. Once you've done that, click on OK, and then you just need to click on File, Save As. On the Save As type, click, select Files, Edit, then just rename the file to, let's say, Acer GE 245HQ, which is my monitor. Okay, and then click on Save. Once you've done that, as you can see here, there's an edit file for my monitor. I would like to thank the person who agreed to help me on providing this file for me, because I am in desperate need for it in order to repair my projector. And if you like this video, you can subscribe, like, or even dislike if you didn't like the video, and because it helps out a lot. And well, this was pretty much my tutorial on how you can extract the edit file and the INF file from a monitor or a projector. So thank you very much. If you want, you can uninstall those two programs from your computer, and you can email those two files, the edit file and the INF file, to the person who needs them. Thank you so much. Bye bye.